Well, it was October 1, 1961, when this fledgling TV station went on the air, our first TV broadcast, and today we celebrate 52 years of broadcasting.
52 years. Happy birthday to you.
To CBN. We've been around for a long time. And we're still going to show you some more. And we've also got a former Speaker of the House of Representatives who locked in battle with President Bill Clinton, who knows firsthand about government shutdowns. Newt Gingrich is going to be with us shortly.
It's going to be an exciting show. And coming up, we're going to be showing you highlights from 5 decades of television. Plus, longtime co-host and friend Ben Kichler is joining us to celebrate those 52 years and his part of that, which was a big part.
He sure was. Well, first in the news, the federal government shutdown has begun. We're all still here, and we're all still alive, and the country still stands. The president and his allies accuse Republicans of extortion and blackmail, but conservatives say the American people want them to fight this battle. Charlene Israel has the story.
Midnight came and went, and still bitterly divided lawmakers refused to budge.
The House has made its position known very clearly.
They've lost their minds.
Only hours before the deadline, the Senate rejected yet another House measure to keep the government open, this time by delaying enforcement of the individual mandate, the requirement in Obamacare that forces the uninsured to buy insurance or pay a fine. The plan also would have stripped lawmakers of their exemption to Obamacare.
Americans don't want Obamacare, and they don't think members of Congress and our staff and the cabinet and the president need to be exempted from Obamacare unless you exempt all of America. And that's the battle that we're talking about here today.
So what will this partial government shutdown look like? For now, about 800,000 government employees will be furloughed. But essential services like air traffic controllers, border patrol agents, and most food inspectors will continue to work. The House and Senate also agreed on a bill to keep the military funded. Now the question is, how long will the standoff last? House Republicans are pushing for a meeting with Senate negotiators to work out a deal.
I would hope that the Senate would accept our offer to go to conference and discuss this so that we can resolve this for the American people.
But Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid says he'll only agree to meet if Republicans agree to stop trying to change Obamacare.
We will not go to conference with a gun to our head.
CBN News Chief Political Correspondent David Brody says in the end, the Republicans hope the American people will see why the stand is necessary.
The question is, once Obamacare starts to be implemented in the next few months, then what will happen? Then all of a sudden, will people say, well, wait a minute, maybe it wasn't such a bad idea that the government shut down for a few days or a week because this Obamacare is an absolute nightmare. That's what the Republicans are hoping for.
Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Well, I worry about a government, a president who demonizes the opposition, who hasn't been anywhere near the negotiations, a Senate that refuses to discuss compromise, to even talk about the fact that the people's house that represents the American people in the terms of our founding fathers, they refuse to negotiate. This is something terrible. Well, coming up, we're going to have an interview with former House Speaker Newt Gingrich, who was in Congress during the last government shutdown. But before we bring him on, let's go to John Jessup for more of today's headlines. Here's John.
Pat, a key piece of the president's health care law rolls out today despite the government shutdown. Online insurance exchanges are available for millions of Americans to shop for medical coverage. The cost to subscribers will vary from state to state. An estimated 48 million Americans do not have insurance. If you don't want to buy or are delaying your decision, you will have 6 months to purchase a plan. After that, you'll face a fine from the government. The earliest coverage will take effect is January 1st. The president has been promoting his health care plan in recent days, but the Associated Press is warning buyers beware in the president's rhetoric. In one statement, he said coverage would probably cost less than your cell phone bill. But he was citing the premium for the cheapest plan. And consumers who choose it will pay as much as 40% of their medical bills out of pocket, significantly higher than the promise. The president also famously said that those who like their health care plans won't be affected, but nothing in the law guarantees health care plans will stay the same. Some companies have already cut back coverage and shifted costs to employees to avoid penalties under the law. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is warning the United Nations and President Obama to not trust Iran. He says Iran's new charm offensive masks a dangerous nuclear agenda. Chris Mitchell has a story from Jerusalem.
Netanyahu's speech at the UN will be one of his most important on the world stage.
He faces a, I would say, probably the biggest diplomatic challenge that I can remember, certainly in the last decade or so.
Former Israeli ambassador to the U.S. Danny Aiello told CBN News Netanyahu faces a skeptical UN after Iran launched its charm offensive. The offensive is designed to convince the West Iran doesn't want to build a nuclear bomb and that the West should lift economic sanctions.
The challenge is not from the sweet talk, the charm offensive of the Iranians. It's the response of the international community. How easily they have been embracing the Iranians without calling them into check. So this is the main challenge, is to tell the world the truth, to set the record straight, and to keep the pressure on Iran.
Before his UN speech, Netanyahu met with U.S. President Obama. His main topic, Iran. Obama says he's willing to talk with the Islamic Republic.
Because of the extraordinary sanctions that we have been able to put in place over the last several years, the Iranians are now prepared, it appears, to negotiate. We have to test diplomacy.
Netanyahu says he wants to see action, not just talk.
It is Israel's firm belief that if Iran continues to advance its nuclear program during negotiations, the sanctions should be strengthened.
While Netanyahu met with U.S. President Obama and faces a U.N. General Assembly, many Israelis remain skeptical about Iran's intentions and the decision by the White House to negotiate an end to Iran's nuclear program. In the meantime, the momentum for diplomacy is building. U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry now says he feels a deal with Iran about its nuclear program could be finished within 3 to 6 months. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
A federal judge is ordering Attorney General Eric Holder to turn over documents concerning Operation Fast and Furious. The Justice Department has refused to comply with House subpoenas. Investigators there are seeking information about the response to the controversial operation targeting gun trafficking at the Mexican border. President Obama has backed up the Justice Department by asserting executive privilege over the documents being withheld. The House has voted to hold Holder in contempt for not turning them over, and on Monday, a judge rejected Holder's attempt to keep the documents private. The Justice Department is suing North Carolina over the state's new voting law. It's the latest effort by the Obama administration to fight back against a Supreme Court ruling that struck down parts of the Voting Rights Act. The North Carolina law cuts early voting by a week and same-day voter registration and includes a photo ID requirement. The Justice Department claims the law threatens the voting rights of minorities by making it harder to vote. Last month, the department also filed suit against Texas over its new voter ID law. Pat, this looks like it sets the stage to what could be a very long and drawn-out multi-state legal battle that could wind up before the Supreme Court all over again.
Well, it looks like the Justice Department is determined to ignore Congress and also to ignore court orders. They just are law unto themselves, and I don't have much confidence in the current Attorney General. So, yes, it'll set up a lengthy process. But if we ignore the constitutional mandates, then of course we'll have serious problems. And we've been having that with our president.
A central part of President Obama's health care law takes effect today. But that isn't good news to some in the medical field. Thousands of Christian doctors across the nation are considering quitting medicine or working overseas. The senior vice president of the Christian Medical Association says they're concerned about Obamacare in fear they could be forced to facilitate abortions or prescribe drugs that violate their convictions. Thousands of the doctors provide care for the poorest areas of the U.S., and many have avoided hiring and taking on new patients due to uncertainty over Obamacare. Iran has denied a pardon to another imprisoned pastor. CBN News has kept you updated on developments with Pastor Saeed Abedini over the last year, but he's just one of many Christians jailed in Iran for their faith. According to Present Truth Ministry, the family of Pastor Benham Irani recently asked an Iranian judge to pardon him, but the judge refused, saying Pastor Irani has to serve the remainder of his six-year sentence. Irani has already served more than 2 years. The judge said the only way Irani would be released early is if he repents and returns to Islam. And you can always get the latest from CBN News by going to our website at cbnnews.com.